Perhaps you're familiar with Abraham Lincoln's immortal words from the Gettysburg Address, the government of the people, by the people, for the people. I fear that these ringing words need to be updated in light of some recent events. First of all, we have Representative Lauren Boebert, Republican from Colorado. She and her date were in a movie theater and, let's just say, couldn't keep their hands to themselves. They got, as they say, handsy. In the immortal words of National Review, there is no defending Lauren Boebert's behavior. For the duration of a movie, she and her date can't keep their hands to themselves. Then, on the other side of the aisle, we have Democrat Susanna Gibson from Virginia, who's running for a seat in the Virginia House of Delegates. She recently, well, actually about a year ago, she and her husband performed pornographic acts on one of these websites where you can upload yourself doing things. And now somebody found out about it, and she's blaming her political opponents for, quote, I'm not making this up, invading her privacy. Even though those videos have been out there on a publicly available site, they had followers that had been out there for a year. Now she's not only blaming her opponents, but she's whining about how there's a double standard about how men are treated versus how women are treated in terms of sexual misconduct. One of her supporters say, this should be the biggest fundraising day of her career. And you're thinking to yourself, really? Speaking of the double standard, we all remember Bill Clinton, some of the things Bill Clinton got away with. Even while there were serious sexual harassment charges lodged against him, he couldn't keep his hands off of a 20-something intern in his office. And I'm thinking to myself, if people can't behave themselves, even when there's a lot at stake, what does that mean? To me, it's a marker, not a diagnosis, I can't give a diagnosis, but it's a marker for sex addiction. Which brings me to something that happened during the pandemic. I don't know if you remember this, but this was something that jumped out at me and all of us here at the Ruth Institute. In 2020, at the height of the pandemic, New York City Department of Health issued some guidelines for sexual behavior during the pandemic. They suggested that people masturbate, and they warned against having group sex, at least while the crisis lasts. Likewise, the Colorado Department of Public Health issued what we called at the time Sodom and Gomorrah health tips. Same sort of things, same sort of suggestions. And, of course, we can't forget Tony Fauci saying to us, well, you know, everyone can decide how much risk that they're willing to take when talking to people about whether or not they should continue to use their dating apps during the crisis, the health crisis. Now, how can this possibly make any sense? There are two possibilities, not mutually exclusive. This could be a both-and situation. Maybe these public health officials didn't really believe that the coronavirus was all that deadly. So maybe that's it. It's also possible, though, that they believed that if they suggested that people should limit their sexual activity, that will fall on completely deaf ears. Even in the face of life-threatening illness, people would be unable to refrain from sex. So, what does that tell you? That tells you that they think we're all sex addicts. Even in the face of life-threatening consequences, we're not going to be able to keep our flies zipped. And this brings me back to the Gettysburg Address and also the preamble to the U.S. Constitution. Perhaps you thought that the purpose of government was to ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, and promote the general welfare. That's so 5 minutes ago. Today, the purpose of government is to give us the sex lives we want with the minimum of inconvenience. We now live in the sexual state. So let's update Abraham Lincoln's words for something more suitable for our time. We now have government of the sex addicts, by the sex addicts, for the sex addicts. As they say on the internet, change my mind. I'm Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse for the Ruth Institute. Thanks for watching.